Let's learn gladiolus in watercolor today. So first, let us take lemon yellow and mix it with canary yellow. So now, when my earlier tone is still not dried, at that time only I have started adding the middle tone little by little. First I finished the flower, as you can see. Now I'm doing the buds. Make sure that your earlier tone is still wet. If it dries, it wouldn't give you this beautiful flowy effect as you can see in the demo. Now, for the green part of the flower, I have taken sap green and added very little of lemon yellow. And I've started doing the young buds on top, then the leaves, the stalk. You will find I'm also taking a little lemon yellow side by side and creating a beautiful two-tone painting. So this is also a kind of light tone that we are adding in all the leaves and the buds and the stalk. Make sure that your color is flowy. Only then the watercolor will look beautiful, as I repeated earlier also. Now, for the middle tone, I've taken the crimson red and the scarlet that you'd seen earlier. Same tones you'll take it here for the dark tone, but this time the proportion is going to be say 80 and 20. That is 80% of your color and 20% of water. So here you can see I have mixed scarlet with little of canary yellow. And very carefully, I'm separating each of the petal by making sure that I'm leaving a little light hairline between the two petals. Also understand, the gladiolus flower that we are doing is a two-tone flower. So it has this scarlet tone mixed with canary yellow. That is the only reason we are trying to maintain this two different colors in one flower. See to it that your color doesn't become too opaque, because that spoils the beauty of the watercolor. So you can decide upon the crimson red and scarlet proportion as per the specimen given to you. It all depends upon your observation. So like this, you will keep doing your scarlet and crimson red further down, even in the buds. Make sure that your petals are separated, and for separation, as I told you, you have to maintain a hairline between the two petals. So what will be seen through that hairline is the light tone that we had done earlier. As you can see in the demo, I'm switching between scarlet and the canary yellow. We'll like this go on completing all the buds. So as you go above, you will find very little of the buds seen because they are not yet bloomed. So now the next part, that is, I'm preparing two different shades. One is that I made with the sap green, and the other one, adding the sap green color to the earlier red mixture that we had in our palette. You will find that all the time the watercolor palette of mine was wet. I did not allow it to dry. Your color shouldn't become powdery. So I'm adding sap green color to all the young leaves and the buds. As you come down towards the flower, you will realize that the mixture of sap green with scarlet increases. Like the amount of this mixture increases. Also, I'm not doing a kind of outline. I put a tone and then with water try to mix it. So as we add the dark tone, we can see that it gives us a beautiful 3D effect in our flower. Don't forget to add tiniest details in your work, because that is what will make your nature drawing very beautiful and realistic. Also, make sure that just to gain realism, you are not losing your artistic touch. So here you can see that because I had added that mixture of crimson red and sap green, how beautifully the 3D effect is created in the flower. So in this painting, I have kept flower as my focal point. So like, also remember one thing in the exam, when they are providing you a specimen, it's just a specimen, you need not copy it as it is. If there are 10 leaves, you need not make 10 of them. You can make a few of them which really are appealing to you. Same goes with the rest of the things, like whether flowers or the buds or whatever the other things that you see in it. So I'm adding the dark tones. Also, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share this video. Subscribe to my channel, and also don't forget to comment. In comment box, write down what other flowers would you like me to make the demo or the video for you guys. So like, next time I'll come up with that. So at the last, I'm adding the finer details, the lines and all, and there we come to an end of this demo. Thank you so much for watching. Do share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.